بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Anticoagulant drug is a substance that prevents coagulation of blood. Such substances occur naturally in leeches and blood-sucking insects. A group of pharmaceuticals called anticoagulant can be used in vivo as a medication for thrombotic disorder. Some anticoagulants are used in medical equipment such as test tube, blood transfusion bag, and renal dialysis equipment. General indication. Therapeutic uses of anticoagulant include atrial fibrillation, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, venous thromboembolism, congestive heart failure, myocardial infarction, and genetic or acquired hypercoagulability. There are types of anticoagulant according to the mode of action. First one, coumarin, which is vitamin K antagonist. Second one, heparin, a derivative substance. Third one, direct factor 10 inhibitor. Fourth one, direct thrombin inhibitor, and others. Coumarin. These oral anticoagulants are derived from the coumarin, which is found in many plants. A prominent member of this class is warfarin. It takes at least 48 to 72 hours for the anticoagulant effect to develop, where an immediate effect is required. Heparin must be given concomitantly. These anticoagulants are used to treat patients with the deep vein thrombosis, atrial fibrillation, pulmonary embolism, and mechanical prosthetic heart valve. Mode of action. Vitamin K antagonists are a group of drugs that reduce blood clotting by inhibiting the recycling of vitamin K epoxide back to the active reduced form of vitamin K. This drug reduces the action of vitamin K by depleting the active form of the vitamin. The term vitamin K antagonist is misnomer, as the drug don't directly antagonize the action of vitamin K, but rather the recycling of the vitamin K. Available agent of vitamin K antagonist is warfarin, is the main agent used in the United States, and acinocumarol and phenoprocumon are used more commonly outside the United States, and atromentin. Second one, heparin and derivative substance. Heparin is biological substance usually made from big intestine. It works by activating antithrombin 3, which blocks thrombin from clotting blood. Heparin can be used in vivo by injection and also in vitro to prevent blood or plasma clotting in or on medical devices. Low molecular weight heparin. A more highly processed product, it's useful as doesn't require monitoring of the active partial thrombin time coagulation parameter. It has more predictable plasma level and has fewer side effects. Mode of action. Heparin and low molecular weight derivative are effective at preventing deep vein thrombosis and pulmonary emboli in patients at risk, but there is no evidence that anyone is more effective than other in preventing mortality. Heparin binds to the enzyme inhibitor antithrombin 3, causing conformational changes that result in its activation through an increase the flexibility of its reactive site loop. The activated antithrombin then inactivates thrombin and other proteases involved in blood clotting, most notably factor 10. The rate of inactivation of these proteases by antithrombin can increase by up to 1000-fold due to binding of heparin. Synthetic pentasaccharide inhibitor of factor 10. Fundaparinux is synthetic sugar composed of 5 sugar pentasaccharide in heparin that bind to antithrombin. It is smaller molecule than low molecular weight heparin. Edraparinux. It has similar chemical structure and the same method of action as fundaparinux, but with an elimination half-life about 5 to 6 times longer, which means that the drug should only need to be injected once a week. Third one, direct factor 10 inhibitor. Drugs such as rivaroxaban and apixaban work by inhibiting factor 10 inhibitor directly, unlike the heparin and fundaparinux, which work via antithrombin activation. Mode of action of rivaroxaban is an oxazolidine derivative optimized for inhibiting both free factor 10 and factor 10 bound in the prothrombinase complex. It is highly selective direct factor 10 inhibitor with oral bioavailability and rapid once of action. Inhibition of factor 10 interrupts the intrinsic and extrinsic pathway of the blood coagulation cascade, inhibiting both thrombin formation and development of thrombi. Rivaroxaban doesn't inhibit thrombin activated factor 2, and no effect on platelets have been demonstrated. Fourth one, direct thrombin inhibitor. Direct thrombin inhibitor are class of medication that act as anticoagulant, delaying blood clotting by directly inhibiting the enzyme thrombin. Some are in clinical use while others are undergoing clinical development. Several members of the class are expected to replace heparin and derivative and warfarin in various clinical scenarios. There are two types of direct thrombin inhibitor dependent on their interaction with the thrombin molecule. First one, bivalent direct thrombin inhibitor, and bind both to the active site and exosite, while univalent direct thrombin inhibitor bind only to the active site. Other type of anticoagulant. Many other anticoagulant exist for use in research and development, diagnosis, or as a drug candidates, such as batroxabine, which is a toxin from a snake venom. Clot platelet rich plasma without affecting platelet function lysis fibrinogen. Second one, hemantin is an anticoagulant protease from the salivary gland of the giant Amazon leech. Thank you.